Sometimes these deals make so much sense that you got to wonder why they took so darn long. Why an online discount broker, Robinhood, eliminated commissions on trading. Well, they're going to make their money on credit balances, meaning your assets. That forced the rest of the industry to follow suit. And because the others made a lot of money from commissions, their stocks were clocked. But Charles Schwab, with $3.8 trillion in assets under management, took advantage of the sad state of the industry, swooping in to buy competitor TD Ameritrade for the relatively low price of $26 billion. And voila, now they have $5 trillion under their belts.
House of pleasure.
I remember a time when Goldman Sachs debated buying little Charles Schwab. Look out, $78 billion Goldman. Schwab's less than $20 billion from you, and it's now gaining on you. Although I have to wonder if Schwab doesn't really have, at this point, a better business model for the future, particularly for those millennials, than Goldman right now. Unless the Apple credit card turns out to be huge, Goldman has some real catching up to do. It could double its assets under management and still not come close to the new Schwab. Lots of critics sneered when they saw how much LVMH, the parent of Louis Vuitton and Moët Hennessy, had to pay for Tiffany, $16 billion, or $135 a share. Given that the stock was at 90 bucks a little over a month ago. But if that was such a bad deal, why has LVMH stock roared higher? Tiffany's had some pretty darn horrible numbers worldwide. I think they simply didn't understand the new retail world that's defined by personalization and high touch. For years, the jewelry chain has missed numbers, frequently blaming the strong dollar, which hurts tourism. At one time, they even blamed Trump for lower traffic after the election. I mean, oh, who knows? They always had something. But you know what? You take something like the riots in Hong Kong. That should hurt companies. It hurt Estee Lauder. You see them complain? No, they sell a ton of expensive cosmetics in Hong Kong. They didn't use an excuse. They may have hurt sales, but Estee Lauder is such a well-run business worldwide that it didn't matter. So it's not just that if you're in the premium category, like Estee, like Tiffany, come on. One does well, the other one doesn't, both EL and then LVMH. Understand high touch. The need to maintain a close connection to your customers. Now, Tiffany's going to learn that, too. I am sure LVMH gets it because this company's been a marquee account for Salesforce.com. You know, they were lauded at Dreamforce last week by Marc Benioff before this deal. He's the co-CEO and founder. The salespeople seem to know everything about you when you shop at one of their stores. Tiffany, on the other hand, they seem to draw a blank when you walk in. When you're shelling out a lot of money for high-end jewelry, you want the people who work there to recognize you, remember your preferences, suggest ideas. I bet their numbers will soar after this takeover closes. Soar! Even in takeovers where the target surge has surged higher, the acquired stocks are rewarded. Novartis. NVS. It snapped up Medicine's company for $9.7 billion this weekend. They're paying a price that's 340% higher than where Medicine's was at the beginning of the year. And what happens? Novartis stock actually rallies a bit. Why? Because they're buying a twice-a-year injection that lowers your cholesterol. The current standard of care requires you to get two shots a month. Fits in perfectly with Novartis' considerable heart franchise. I think the lower the cholesterol, we're going to find out, fewer the heart attacks, the more that Novartis is going to look like a genius for buying this. All right, now, if acquirers are being rewarded for snapping up other companies, that tells me that these stocks may be a lot cheaper than you think, and many stocks may be cheaper. And once you start seeing this kind of action, other businesses are encouraged to make deals too. So you can expect more mergers going forward. It's axiomatic, people. It will happen.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.